everyone. I welcome you all over here for the tutorial Basics of NLP Using SPACY Part 3. Okay, now over here we're gonna cover vocab, hashes, and lexemes and NER with transformers. Fine, so basically, I'm talking about this class, vocab class. This contains all the vocab of the complete, you know, when we pass a document, then inside the NLP pipeline, then all the vocab or all the tokens or words will be there in the that will be contained in the vocab class, okay, and all the details about those words, like, you know, their entity labels, their part of speech tags, and further more details about those tokens will be there in the vocab class. Now those details and those words will be accessed by doc class as well and the string store class as well for their further processes. Now if we talk about string store class, so this class encodes all the strings, that means all the tokens or words, to their hash values, and even it encodes entity labels like person, date, and org to their hash values, and even posttags like verb, adverbs, nouns, adjectives, etc. to their hash values for further memory optimization. Okay, now so with the help of this hash value for any string or token or word, we can access all the details about it, like entity name, the post tag, and the lemma, etc. Fine. Now how can we do that? Let's see. So over here, first of all, I'm loading the model. After that, I'm using the object of it, and I'm passing the text in it. Okay, I'm passing the text in it. After that, you can see I'm for this I want the hash value for this token, okay, for this word coffee. For this string, I want the hash value. So with the help of this vocab.string function, it is giving me this hash value for it. Fine. Now again, if you copy this hash value and you will pass inside it again the same function dot strings of the vocab class, then it will give you the string back. So it will work vice versa. If you pass the string, it will give you hash value, and if you pass the hash value, it will give you the string, corresponding string. Now let's look over here. So the same thing happening over here. I have to I love copy the same sentence. Fine. Now the same thing is happening over here as well. Now let's move further. So yeah, now I want to access all the details about, you know, all the tokens in that text. So this is my text, and I want to access all the details of these tokens. So what I'm gonna do, first of all, I will create an object, and I will for that text, okay, and then I will, with the help of that object and with the help of the vocab class, I gonna, you know, access all the details. Like it will give dot text will give me token. Fine, that means I love and this coffee are the tokens. Fine. Now this lexeme.orth, this will give me the hash value corresponding these tokens. So what is the hash value for corresponding to the I? This is the hash value for the corresponding to the I. This is the hash value for the love, and this is the hash value for the coffee. Now lexeme.shape will give you the shape that we already discussed, okay. Now lexeme.prefix will give you the prefix. So for the I, the prefix is I, okay, and for the love, the prefix is L, and for the coffee, the prefix is C. Fine. Now lexeme.suffix will give you the suffix. Fine. So over here for the I, suffix is I itself. For the love, suffix is OVE, like three, up to three letters. Fine. And for the coffee, the suffix is FWP. Fine. Now further detail we can access like this, like is alpha, is digit. Fine. And is title, what will does it title do? That means if first letter is capital, then this will be true. So over here for I, this will be true, and for all for other two words, it will be false. Okay, and is digit will check whether the token contain any digit. Okay, so it will give you false for all these three tokens. Okay, and is alpha will check whether these token contain all the letters in this token will be alphabet or not. So if like I is also alphabet, love is also contain alphabets, and coffee is also contain alphabets, so this will become true. Fine. True, true, and true. Now lexeme.language, so it will give us the token in which language that token is. So it is in the English, so that's why it is giving you en E-N-E-N. Like this, with the help of the vocab class, okay, we can see all the details, okay, of a particular, we can of a token or a word or a vocab. Fine. Now, NER with transformers. So basically, what is a transformer? A transformer is a deep learning model that uses the mechanism of attention and weighing the influences of different parts of the input data. And transformers are designed to handle sequential input data, like natural language data or natural language text. Okay, that data which is in the natural language format. Okay, and for performing the tasks like translation and text summarization, etc. Okay, so that is known as transformer. Now, further, how to install the library for the transformer? Yeah, one more thing. Transformers were first introduced in 2017 and 18, and SPACY introduced its library SPACY-Transformer in 2019. Now, this library SPACY-Transformer connects SPACY with the Hugging Face Transformers library. Okay, now let's see how to install that. So for installing that library, you can use this command. Okay, and for downloading that transformer model, you can use this command. Fine. Now, once you are done with this part, so what you have to do, let's see like how we have to implement it. For seeing the visualization, we have to import the DisplayC class from the SPACY library. Okay, now I am loading my model. Okay, and its object is nlp.trf. Okay, now I am loading, this is my transformer model and this is my normal English language large model. That was English language transformer model and this is English language large model. Now I am loading these two models, and the object of this one is NLP underscore TRF and the object of this one is NLP. Now I am passing this text, okay, inside these with the help of these objects in the model. Okay, so what will happen when we see the visualization of it? So first of all, I am passing for in the transformer model, okay, the text. So it will give me like, as the sentence is very normal, like, okay, we can't see the much difference over here. Apple is organization, then $143 is money, this date is date. Similarly, the same you will get for the English large model as well. Now, but if I talk about a sentence which will be a little bit confusing, let's see how does transformer model will perform on that. Okay, so this is my text. So over here we can see this is a organization name that released its Q1 21 performance on Thursday. Now let's see how does transformer model will visualize it, and how does or process it, or how does normal English model, large English model will process it. Okay, so we can see over here, when I pass this text in the object of NLP TRF, that is of the transformer model. So with the help of this render function, I am displaying it entities. Okay, and in the style I'm passing ENT because I want to display the entities. So it is giving fastly as organization, that is correctly predicted Q1 21 as date. Now you can see when we pass this doc inside the large model of the English language, which has the object NLP, and we are looking for the entities of that model as we did above as well over here. Fine. So it is telling us fastly is a person. Oh, okay. And it is not recognizing this at all. Fine. So there are some few difference, or we can say a few improvement we can see with the help of transformers. Fine. So over here, few more differences if we can see. Yeah. So over here you can see like this one. This one recognizing CFO as ORG, but the CFO is not ORG. This is the post name, right? So this is recognizing it perfectly. The transformer model doesn't recognize it because this is a normal post name. We can say designation. Okay, and this is CFO. This is this. It is recognizing it. This a large English model is recognizing it as we can say organization. So which is wrong? Fine. So we have does improvement with the help of the transformer model. Okay, so thank you very much, guys. In the next class, we're gonna cover the project text classification, okay, with the help of